welcome to worship. It is so good to be together. Isn't it so good to be together?
Yes.
This is just wonderful. I have no announcements for you. Are we good to go with the cameras? All right, well then let us begin this beautiful evening of worship together by listening to some wonderful music by Mona and Dave.
Thank you.
Lord God, as we light this candle to remind us of your hope, peace, joy, and love, help us to witness to the light of the world, your Son, Jesus, who came as a babe at Bethlehem and will come again in glory. Grant that we may be candles and mirrors of your light to a dark and waiting world. Come, Lord Jesus. Let us pray. Eternal God,
this holy night is radiant with the brilliance of your one true light. May that light illuminate our hearts and shine in our words and deeds. May the hope, the peace, the joy, and the love represented by our birth in Bethlehem this night fill our lives and become part of all that we say and do. May we share the divine life of your Son, Jesus Christ, even as he humbled himself to share our humanity. Amen.
Our scripture, we will hear and focus the rest of our worship on Mary. We know that as we come together to celebrate the promise fulfilled, the promise of a baby to a young virgin, the promise of a savior for us all, that fulfilled promise also echoes generations of the faithful who were waiting for promises fulfilled, and they all found that fulfillment in Jesus Christ. So as we hear about Mary, as we hear about how this story snugly fits into generations of faithful before her waiting for God, I hope we will also consider all the ways that God has answered promises in our own lives. Let us listen to our scripture reading to begin with.
Gabriel, messenger of God, spoke to a virgin from Nazareth named Mary and told her,
"You will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus.
He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David.
He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end."
Mary said,
"Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word."
Mary hurried to a town in the hill country of Judea, where she entered Zechariah's home and greeted Elizabeth.
When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit.
In a loud voice, she exclaimed,
"Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child you will bear.
Blessed is she who believed that the promise was made by the Lord
would be fulfilled."
And Mary said,
"My soul glorifies the Lord,
and proclaims the greatness of the Lord.
My spirit exults
and rejoices in God my Savior.
For he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. From this day forward, all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One,
the Almighty,
has done great things for me.
Holy is his name.
His faithful love extends to all who fear him, from generation to generation,
from one age to the next.
He has performed mighty deeds with his arm.
He has routed the arrogant of heart.
He has pulled down rulers from their thrones,
but has lifted up the lowly.
He has filled the hungry with good things,
but has sent the rich away empty.
He has come to the help of his servant Israel, fully mindful of his faithful love,
according to the promise he made to our ancestors,
fully mindful of his mercy to Abraham and to his descendants forever.
Mary stayed with Elizabeth for about 3 months and then returned home.
Thank you.
Mary was blessed.
For she believed that what the Lord had said to her would be fulfilled.
She spoke as with the heart and voice of Hannah.
And many others of God's people before her.
Hannah had prayed to the Lord in the bitterness of her soul that he would remove the shame of her barrenness.
And when God had blessed her, she dedicated her son Samuel to the Lord, saying,
My heart exalts in the Lord. In my God is my strength lifted up. There is no holy one like the Lord. Indeed, there is none but you. There is no rock like our God.
The bows of the mighty are broken, but the feeble and all girded with strength.
Those who were full are hiring themselves out for bread, but the hungry need labor no more.
The barren woman bears sevenfold, but the mother of many is left desolate.
The Lord makes poor and makes rich. He brings low, he exalts.
He raises up the poor from the dust. He lifts the needy from the ash heap to give them a place with princes and assign them a seat of honor.
For the pillars of the earth are the Lord's, and on them he has set the world.
Mary was blessed.
For she believed that what the Lord had said to her would be fulfilled.
She spoke as with the heart and voice of Eliphaz.
And many others of God's people before her.
Eliphaz was Job's friend, who counseled him after he received his great misfortune, saying,
The works of God are great, past all reckoning, marvelous things without number.
He sends down rain to the earth, pours down water on the fields.
He sets on high those who are lowly, and those who mourn are lifted to safety.
The Lord frustrates the plans of the crafty, so that they cannot succeed in their intrigues. He traps the wise in the snare of their own trickery, throws the plans of the cunning into disarray.
But he saves the needy from the sword of their mouth, from the hand of the mighty.
So the poor have hope, and injustice must shut its mouth.
Thank you.
Mary was blessed.
For she believed that what the Lord had said to her would be fulfilled.
She spoke as with the heart and voice of Leah.
And many others of God's people before her.
Leah, the wife of Jacob, exclaimed at the birth of their son, Asher, saying,
"What happiness! All women will call me blessed."
Thank you.
Mary was blessed.
For she believed that what the Lord had said to her would be fulfilled. She spoke as with the heart and voice of the psalmist and many others of God's people before her.
My soul praises God from my heart. Let the humble hear and be glad. Proclaim with me the greatness of the Lord. Let us acclaim his name together. Holy is he and mighty. You are a king who loves justice, who insists on honesty, justice, and virtue, as you have done for Jacob.
Sing a new song to the Lord, for he has performed wonders. His right hand and his holy arm have scattered his enemies and gained for him the victory.
When the Lord builds Zion anew, he will be seen in his glory. He will answer the prayer of the abandoned and will not scorn their petitions. God leaned down from the heights of his sanctuary, has looked down from heaven to earth to hear the sighing of the captive and to set free those condemned to die.
He raises the poor from the dust. He lifts the needy from the ash heap to give them a place among the princes. He lets the barren women be seated at home, the happy mothers of sons.
He has fed the hungry to their heart's content and filled the starving with good things.
The steadfast love of the Lord for those who fear him lasts from everlasting to everlasting, and his saving justice to his children's children, to those who keep his covenant and remember to do his commandments.
He remembers his covenant forever, the promise he laid down for 1,000 generations. Covenant he made with Abraham, the oath he swore to Isaac.
Thank you.
Mary was blessed.
For she believed that what the Lord had said to her would be fulfilled.
She spoke as with the heart and voice of Isaiah.
And many others of God's people before her.
Isaiah was a prophet of the Lord who proclaimed God's might and justice.
The Lord is the everlasting God. His understanding is beyond fathoming.
He gives strength to the weary.
He strengthens the powerless.
Young men may grow tired and weary. The young stumble and fall.
But those who hope in the Lord will regain their strength. For thus says the high and exalted one, whose name is holy.
I live in a high and holy place, but I am also with the contrite and the humble.
To revive the spirit of the humble.
To revive the heart of the contrite.
Here is the sovereign Lord coming with power, his arms subduing all things to him.
The prize of his victory is with him.
He reduces princes to nothing,
the rulers of the world to mere emptiness.
I shall recount the Lord's acts of faithful love, God's praises, in return for all that God has done for us.
For his great kindness to the house of Israel.
And for all that he has done in his mercy.
For the abundance of his acts of faithful love.
With her one voice.
Mary spoke with the voices of many of God's people who came before her.
At the same time, she addressed all those who come after her.
She spoke of promises of mercy and salvation fulfilled.
And of promises yet to be fulfilled.
My soul glorifies the Lord.
And proclaims the greatness of the Lord.
My spirit exalts.
And rejoices in God my Savior.
Thanks be to God for promises fulfilled. And as you draw strength from the promises of this evening, I pray that the year ahead will be full of promises fulfilled for each of us. Let's join together in our responsive prayer. On this holy night, O God, we turn our hearts to you. You are our hope, our light, and our salvation.
On this holy night, O God, we celebrate the joy of your coming and yearn to be born.
On this holy night, O God, we celebrate the mystery of your coming, awed at how you humbled yourself to be one with us.
On this holy night, O God, we welcome the Christ child, born in the barn among the animals, wrapped in the bands of cloth, and laid in a feeding trough.
On this holy night, O God, we rejoice in your Son, Jesus our Savior.
Amen.
It is truly a joy to share the light of Christ with one another. I will begin passing the light to each of you. I would remind you that if you are the one with the light, it works really well if you keep your candle upright And if you are the one receiving the light, please dip it into the candle. Let us join together in this beautiful time of sharing the light.